Picked up this 82 CX500 Turbo a couple days ago. It's pretty nice. Extremely clean. It's got 14,000 miles on it. Rode it today. Surprisingly, quite fun to ride. A little bit heavy for 500, but it doesn't feel like a 500. It feels like you're riding a bigger bike. Got decent power too for a 500. It's my first CX500 Turbo, so I've never experienced one before. But yeah, I'm digging it. It's be a nice trip bike because this fairing is really high. It really protects you a lot. I have mostly sport bikes, so I don't have anything with a fairing quite this tall. It's 55 inches because I didn't think it was going to fit in my trailer. Actually, it didn't. I had to take the windscreen and the mirrors off to get it in. But yeah, I'm digging it. What's popping, people? Oh, and Nick, here's that CX500 Turbo I picked up the other day. I don't know if you guys seen the first video, but all this was kind of mulched, but I do my paint work fast. Came out pretty good. Still got a little bit of dirt needs to be wiped off. I'll let this decal set for a day or two, then wax it. But yeah, it's a pretty cool bike, pretty clean. It's a big turbo on the exhaust, but the wheels and all are real nice. The body's real nice. It's only got 14,000 miles on it. And one thing about the CX500 Turbo, you never have to worry about dirty carbs because it's fuel injected. Always starts right up, man. Pretty simple dash though, like an old car dash. It does have the turbo thing in the center there, up there. Shows you your boost. I haven't ridden it yet. I'm gonna go ride it right now. Got 2025 tags on there, so I'm gonna go take it for a ride. But you know, this bike's kind of an oddball because it's not plastic, it's fiberglass, which I didn't know. So I started getting into the body work. This is all fiberglass, not ABS. And all the materials, like this grab bar, it's like, seems extra quality. Like, more than the 82 Hondas. You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of the 82 CBX. The quality that builds there. In fact, I think it's the same monoshock, mono suspension. What did they call that in the CBX, the 82 that no one liked? Anyway, I think it's the same suspension. But yeah, I picked it up reasonable because it had body damage. And both sides here and here. It got hit in a garage or something. So the pipes aren't touched, so it didn't go down. And these aren't scraped up. So, don't know what caused the damage, but the two front decals were gone. These two were wiped, scraped through, and it scraped into the fiberglass. So I had to sand down. Luckily, most of the damage was under the decals. So the only paint work I really had to do was this and the edge. So I cheated underneath the decals. The paint's not so great. That's okay though. It's an 82 bike. It's pretty nice shape for 82. Yeah, this is all fiberglass. Didn't know they used fiberglass in Honda. All right, well, I'm gonna go ride. It's a super hot day here. I don't know why. It's like 80, gonna be 85 degrees today in Minnesota. So, all right, guys, have a great day and happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. See you later. Going on, kids. Today we're looking at the Benelli 250 Quattro. This bike was made in the late 70s and early 80s. Likes to be revved at high RPM. It's already warmed up, so don't worry that I'm revving it. It likes to be up in the high RPM. I thought the red line till 10. Or no, till 11. Or 12. 12 is the red line. And it likes to be ridden like a two-stroke. You know, there's a lot of history in the Benelli 250. Benelli first made a 250 four-cylinder in 1939. And that bike was water-cooled and supercharged. It's called the compressor bike. And very special bike. But yeah, they, in the late 70s, they decided to remake the 254, and this was it. One of the first bikes that I know of, they used plastic. All plastic. Plastic tank, plastic side covers, except for the front fender. I don't know why the front fender's metal. Plastic tank. No master cylinder or reservoir. The reservoir's under here, and the master's under the tank for the front brakes, which is unusual. This particular bike is very unmolested. It's only got 4 miles on it, so kind of a museum piece. Yeah, neat bike. Like to be ridden like a two-stroke, high RPMs. Top speed, I think, was 92 or 94, somewhere in there, 90. So weighs not much, I think 270. So pretty light. Neat little bike. And there she is, Benelli 250 four-cylinder. Thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it, and really appreciate if you shared my videos. Thanks, man. Have a great day. Something we definitely don't see in America. This is a 53 Moto V twin two-stroke. I just pulled it off the museum floor, pointed at it, and they said everything in here runs. So I'm putting them to the test. Only so far, only one we couldn't get started. Oh, look at that. Instantaneously. If you're going to buy a Moto V, this is the one you want. Yeah, awesome bike. All right, guys, I'll show you some more. What's up, guys and girls? Ellie Nick in Altadena, California, with my friend Johnny, who I met through Barry Wise from Storage Wars, and he built this fantastic bike. It is fantastic. Now, this bike had that spring hub in the rear originally, right?
Not the sprung hub, but they had rigid and sprung hubs.
Okay,
so it could have. Well,
you don't know which one it was.
Some came with rigid wheels,
right?
But it would have been a rigid frame.
But not a swing arm.
No, no. It was. This was a swinging arm conversion that was done by a Triumph of Burbank. Bill Martin was a dealer in the 1950s, and basically he raced sprint cars in the 1930s, and he thought if he can work out a way to get some suspension in his sprint cars, because they were all rigid back in the day,
sure,
he'd be able to keep the fourth wheels on the ground and get more power. which he did in the 30s, and he ended up winning races. So he wanted to apply that technology to a motorcycle. So in 1952, I believe it was, he built three swinging arm conversions to race at Big Bear. One was to be raced by himself, one by his son, and another one by a gentleman called Vern Robeson. Now, as it happens, the Big Bear Enduro came around. Very grueling race. $500,000 entrance.
Yeah.
25, 30 people finish it. Literally. That.
Yeah, brutal.
Brutal race.
Yeah.
And so he thought, well, if I build this swinging arm, and I can, you know, it's going to give me more power, it's going to give me an advantage anyway. Bill ended up going out with a flat tire. His son ended up going out with a bad clutch. But Vern Robeson, big guy, big fellow as well. He ate too many pies, but, you know, he ended up winning the Big Bear Enduro in 1954.
On this bike?
Not on this bike, okay. But on a Triumph Thunderbird with the swinging
arm. With the swing arm kit.
Yeah.
So did they sell this kit?
It was for sale, yeah.
Really?
It was advertised for sale. For $100.
$100.
And basically, you would, for instance, here's a rigid stock frame.
Right.
You would basically unbolt the rear
section.
Right,
they unbolt, yeah.
Take it off.
And put this
and
on.
And put the new one on. And he used shock absorbers from a Chrysler.
I was going to say, are these Dodge or Chrysler?
They're front shocks from a Chrysler automobile.
Yeah, I look
and
familiar.
This was the typical Wassel. Yeah.
So the kit just came with the frame and the shocks.
Just the frame, the shocks, yeah. And the fender. Yeah.
Oh, and the fender.
Yeah, that
for
came
$100.
For $100.
God, what a deal.
Exactly. And so basically he won the Big Bear Enduro with it, which is a good, you know, feather in the cap. And he started advertising them and selling them, and he sold them for several years after that event. But then in 1954 Triumph came out with their own swing arm,
sure.
Which kind of made them a bit.
Do you think they copied him?
Well,
swing arms were on a lot of bikes, though.
Not really that many in '52. I mean,
there
was plungers in Italian bikes, yeah. But as far as the Brit stuff,
no. But Italians all had swing arms.
They did.
Yeah, even pre-war.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. He actually made a swinging arm as well for the front, like Earl's type fork, BMW
sure.
deal. He actually made one of them for the front as well.
Leading link. That's exactly. Barry's right. Leading link.
That's right. So, but yeah, then the pipes I had made, and it uses a stock TR5 gas tank.
I think you should paint that black.
Yeah, that's going to be that's what Barry said. And
it'll go away.
Yeah, it needs to go away. Yeah. It takes away from the whole aesthetic.
Yeah.
Not that I'm putting the bike down. Oh, it's beautiful.
No.
That just annoys me.
He knows.
He mentioned that. But the rest of it is a stock TR5. This is 1949 TR5,
yes,
by the way.
Early,
which
man.
Is a unique bike in
yeah,
itself
early.
Because it's got the unique square barrel.
Yeah.
The square barrels were basically surplus from World War II, where Triumph built these generators for the RAF.
Most important question. Does it run?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Can we hear it?
Does it run?
It's not prepared to run
okay,
today,
so
it but
does
it
run.
Does run.
Okay.
Of course it runs. Does Dolly Parton sleep on her back? Everything this guy's got runs.
I don't know. It might start, but I don't.
I don't want to put you under any...
So
I don't want to put you on the spot,
no,
man.
No, but I'm surprised you never want to hear it.
Well, I did, but that was my...
I don't want to put you on the spot.
Oh, they're so... I mean...
Johnny on the spot.
Everyone wants to hear him run, man.
But, I haven't started it.
It would be great.
That's all right. If it doesn't start, that's fine.
That's right. We'll edit it out.
Well, yeah.
Exactly, right?
I don't edit, but...
I'd love to hear it run.
If it doesn't start, that's fine.
Maybe. Sounding better. Nope. It's probably the carburetor blocked up.
Well, it's leaking.
Oh, is it
yeah, no, but it's leaking some fuel.
Out of the overflow?
No, just...
That's what it's meant to do.
Out of the carb, yeah.
It is leaking, but it wants to go.
Yeah, but he's going to get tired of kicking it.
Yeah. Don't worry.
Especially in the sun.
There.
It ain't no big deal.
Give it one more.
Oh, you know what? It looks to me like that kill button's stuck.
Oh,
it is.
Well, let's undo the kill.
That's definitely stuck.
Bold move or rookie mistake, Johnny?
That is definitely stuck. Kill switch is definitely stuck.
All right, let's see what happens now.
This bike is so special.
Good looking.
Sounds like it's
money right there, man. Yeah, it is. Fantastic, man. All right, guys, thanks for watching, man. We're going to shoot some more. We got a lot of bikes here. See ya.